The starting point of this research was that we often heard from supply managers that they're not expert in everything. In their role as boundary spanners, supply managers often need to talk with different colleagues and ask for their functional expertise. They may do it in front of the entrance, in office kitchen, or simply in an elevator ride. This picture of supply managers' daily business led us to ask ourselves, to what extent such informal interactions might affect the supply manager's formal collaborations with his colleagues. We have turned the spotlight on cross-functional sourcing teams because this is one critical format in which supply managers fulfill their role as intra-organizational boundary spanners. When we look at the supply chain management literature, what really surprised us and finally led us to continue with this research was that cross-functional sourcing teams were largely conceptualized as starting with a clean slate. But sociology and social psychology told us that overlooking previous interactions might limit our understanding of team dynamics. Broadly speaking, this research investigates the effects of informal interactions that have taken place prior to the formation of the cross-functional sourcing team and formal sourcing team collaboration. In our research, these informal pre-team interactions were embodied by advisory exchanges, with the supply manager as the advisee and colleague for another function as the advisor. In particular, we look into how the advisor reacted in two cases. First, to supply manager's rejection of a piece of informal advice, and then to certain mitigation strategies supply managers can deploy to alleviate the potential negative implications that came from previous advice rejection. Methodologically, we first employed experimental study to test the theoretical predictions, and then conducted the sequential interviews to interpret and expand beyond quantitative evidence. The results show that pre-team informal advice exchanges did affect during-team formal collaboration. In particular, advice rejection in a previous informal encounter reduced an advisor's willingness to provide advice to the supply manager in a cross-functional sourcing team. We found that this negative impact went even further to impair the advisor's expectation about the team cohesion. These results held regardless of the advisor's expertise level in the focal area. But when it comes to the effectiveness of mitigation strategies, advisors with low expertise were responsive to all strategies we have tested. But it's not a case for knowledgeable advisors. They only responded positively when elaborate explanation had been provided or when two strategies have been used in combination. For instance, an advance warning plus a simple explanation. These quantitative findings were enriched by our interviews. For instance, in regard to why all tested strategies worked for knowledgeable advisors, we have noted broad concurrence among our interviewees saying that knowledgeable advisors simply appreciate the fact that they receive a response from the supply manager and evaluate it as an act of politeness. The extent supply chain management literature largely conceptualizes cross-functional sourcing team as a clean slate, that means insulated from influences of prior encounters. We went beyond this traditional research approach and have shown that previous informal advising exchanges can influence formal cross-functional sourcing collaboration. We believe that informal interactions are especially relevant to the supply management function because it must seek input from internal stakeholders, liaise between them and the suppliers, and also communicate its own value to other functions within the firm. Therefore, it will be value-adding to look into supply managers' informal interactions with internal stakeholders. Further, we have used narrow-based experiment to test our hypothesis. It is appropriate for our research purpose, but this method inevitably limits the variety of mitigation strategies that were presented to the participants. Therefore, future research can use, for instance, ethnographic methods to inductively explore archetypes of mitigation strategies. Such an inductive approach will also allow researchers to better understand, for instance, under which context the mitigation strategies might differ, like different recognition of the supply management function. Supply managers often go to colleagues with different functional backgrounds for advice. In these informal encounters, they not only get input from internal colleagues, but also potentially start the value of supply management function. We will say, watch out for potential ramifications of these informal advice exchanges, because they might cast a shadow on your future interactions with these colleagues if the provided advice is not taken. To preemptively counteract the potential negative implications of advice rejection, supply managers will need to deploy certain mitigation strategies and tailor them to the advisor's expertise level in the area where the advice was initially needed. But none of the strategies we have tested seem to fully attenuate negative impact. We will therefore caution supply managers against a rather casual "may I pick your brain" strategy, which they seem to frequently use in daily interactions with internal colleagues.